I would like to give a very, very short picture about the application of robotics nowadays in medicine in order to give you the opportunity to place the RealRob into this very wide field. You see that there are robots used for assisting people, robots used for surgery, and then now the RealRob project. We call it a therapeutic system. You will see later on that it has two parts. Then I would like to speak shortly about the future. Namely, this project was not stopped after the funding from Brussels was finished. And it will be very short. Basically, when there are disabled people, the problem is how to control the robot. This patient is controlling the robot by moving the eyes. The camera is watching the eye motion. In this case, he is controlling the robot motion with the jaw. In this case, also, the patient controls with a joystick the robot feeding him. Not only the arms are hurt, but sometimes also the legs. This robot is assisting this patient to learn again walking. This robot, controlled by a joystick, is feeding the patient. This robot is assisting someone to learn walking again. And this robot is assisting a patient bedridden. Surgery. Very good. Surgeon cannot move as accurate as a robot. It is very important, for example, in medical application, like in brain surgery, where a so-called hexapod robot can place 0.1 millimeter accurate the surgery's knife, for example. This again, a robot which can do the hip surgery, even producing a new implant for the hip patient. This is a robot in action. It is a so-called SCARA type robot. This Mullos robot is one of the most used robot in the world. You can see it is adjusted to the wheelchair, and it is helping the hand of the patient to move according to the wish. This is the same story. The patient's left hand is injured, and then the robot is assisting to move. It is used for training purposes, first of all. The first picture I'm showing you, an industrial robot, namely this Puma robot, is a well-known industrial robot. It follows the motion of the right hand of the patient, and it is closest to our purposes. In the virtual reality, the haptic devices are very widely used. One of those applications can be seen here, where the robot is behaving as if you were really grasping something. By the way, the patient is Dr. Fazekas, our medical partner in Hungary. This is something like this previous haptic. This is again assisting the motion of the patient. Not only the hands, legs can be injured. It is a very complicated Swiss project which can assisting to learn again the walking. Now finally we are in RealRob. The RealRob was in the primarily in the 1.22 part of this IST key action line, and secondary in the 1.3.1. The duration was 42 months. It was extended by 6 months. 288 person months were spent in this project, and this project total cost was, say, 1.6 million euro, and because of the industrial partners, the European Commission's funding was a little bit less. It was a quite large project. In the first row, you can see the partners, universities from Cardiff to Russia in Bulgaria, and our university, the Budapest University of Technology and Economics, and an industrial partner, Zebris GmbH in Germany, and then the medical partner was the National Institute for Medical Rehabilitation in Hungary in Budapest. Contributors, a lot of Hungarian companies. The main contributor is ABB Robotics in Sweden, we were connected through Austria to this company. This is the so-called Rearup triangle, representing, symbolizing almost all of the key players of this game. First of all, it is the patient, then the physiotherapist. There is no way that the human being will be totally replaced, as it was mentioned previously. And then there is the Rearup cell. You know, in the medical application of any kind of equipment, security is the first, even when you are planning to use a new knife. This Rearup cell has, for example, a very important part, which is the physiotherapy monitoring and documentation system. And you can read here what kind of information are used and collected during this one. Then electromyography is also used. And we use the dummy limb, like when you are testing a new car, you are using dummy drivers. Two industrial robots, four torque sensors, and there are two very important pieces. One is the high-level PC. It is responsible for everything. And then there is a so-called watchdog PC. Later on, I will tell some more words about it. But without the physiotherapist, we cannot do anything. You can see here the interactions of this triangle. Innovation potential. Actually, 69% of the stroke patient can be cured either totally or partially. It is half-half. This physiotherapy monitoring and documentation system is actually a three-dimensional monitoring system which can document the three-dimensional motion of the patient in any status of this therapy. Then the other is this robotized cell which can do a three-dimensional, free programmable therapy, replacing partly the physiotherapists. Exploitation strategy. We very shortly realized that in this project there are two almost independent marketable achievements. One is this from the Zebris GmbH in Germany. It is a diagnostic system using ultrasound to detect the motion of the human arm. And the second is this Rearup cell. We are here responsible for marketing this. I will tell only some words about this Zebris physiotherapy PMDS system. The achievements reached in Rearup are basically to adapt such kind of motions and measuring the methods which are arised due to this robotized physiotherapy. Zebris has already sold five such kind of devices only in Hungary, so for them it was already a success. There are so-called active sensors, ultrasound markers on the arm. Then those are the movements this Zebris system can detect, which are marked with red, were added by the Hungarian medical partner to this system. They have a catalog which is containing actually all of the motions partially paralyzed people can do or try to do with his or her hand. I have to mention that all of the pictures you see here are pictures of physiotherapists or volunteers, so we follow the rule in this way also. It is the documentation module. I will summarize it in one sentence. Measuring out the capability of the patient, we can document all of the range of motions, we can document the way of measuring out these motions. We can separate the identity of the person from the measuring data to protect the civil rights, and so on and so on. And we can even compare the previous results with the new results. Why such kind of system like ReArub. Only in the European Commission's population, 0.8 to 1.5% of the population might be hemiparetic, or he is already hemiparetic. You can see the most common causes of getting hemiparetic. It means that some side is healthy, the other is not. Most common is, especially in Eastern Europe, is the stroke. It is a positor, the so-called Wernicke-Mann pattern. You see, it is the usually requested way of showing someone. I am sure that most of you have already met some such people. It is, for us engineers, it is a controlling problem, namely the brain sends false information to the muscles. Why robotize the physiotherapy? Some data. One physiotherapist can handle 4 patients. One therapy lasted almost 1 hour. A courses, it means that 2 times 1 hour rehabilitation lasts almost 1 month. The costs in the European Union for 1 day, 700 euros. In the States, 1,400 euros. So it is a very, very costly and very heavy job. You can see here, it is the only one movie I am using, how it is done by mostly women. It is listed the very complicated task of this exercises. It is the task of the physiotherapist. Constant velocity. For human being, it is almost impossible. Please try to move you with your hand 2 times with the same velocity. It is almost impossible. Then, it is really a physical and mental load. Some people are saying it is as strong as going down to the mine and to dig a hole. We developed a catalog for 45 different kinds of exercises, because all over the world there are different methods of human rehabilitation. You can see it is a very interesting development that such kind of catalog already exists. It was many, many times downloaded from our homepage. Some Hungarian. It is the same exercise I showed you previously. It is the exercise 8. Starting position, ending position. Objectives of this research. To design a two-arm robotized exercising system which can perform a full anatomic, I mean all of the range of the motion of the patients, exercising procedure which is aimed for the shoulder and which is aimed for the elbow and for the arm. Left-handed patient, right-handed patients, lying position, sitting position. Market situation. Those are equipments not good for hemiparetic patients. Usually they are used after sport accidents, skiing and then, for example, skydiving. So, finally, there is no such device in the market which can replace ReArub. The market is open. Before we ordered the robots, we made a lot of simulations. One case is here. You can see the position of the physiotherapist. And we used the old way of programming robots. It is the lead-through programming, which is nowadays considered as not very up-to-date. This is the design. And this is now the system, which is in action in the rehabilitation institution. I will be here tomorrow, and you can see the videos showing this system in action. 3 lying positions and 2 sitting positions can be seen and programmed. This is the seat, which is very expensive, is specialized for these purposes, and those are the 6 programmable positions of the robotized system. This is how it starts. Safety. This limited speed 250 millimeter per second means that even human beings are allowed to be in the working envelope of the robot. The watchdog is measuring the registered data during the programming, and when there are deviations, it stops automatically the device, and of course the patient can itself, or himself, herself, sorry, stop immediately the action. It was the first test with a plastic tube. I will go a little bit faster. This is a safety relaxing mechanism. All devices are for the safety. It is a touch screen which is actually hiding what is going behind. This is a 8 degree of freedom dummy limb which was for test. It was developed by the University of Russia. This is again this one. For people familiar with control engineering, this drawing is explaining why the training is not so easy with such kind of up-to-date industrial robots. This is the user interface. You can program the already taught in projects. This is how to connect. This video won't run here. It will last 8 minutes, but you can see it tomorrow. Standardization. We realized that the robot application in rehabilitation needs some background. The best background in the safety is the standard. We make a so-called new work item proposal for the safety of those robots, and it was a voting. You see, United States, for the United States, it is out of scope. I am himself a member of this committee, but I was not able to convince them to say no. But in the new robot standard, industrial robot standard for safety, it is mentioned already that not only for non-industrial robot applications, surgery or healthcare. The chairman of this group is an American. Clinical trial. We have obtained an ethic permission in Hungary, and we run a trial, 7,200 minutes, and it is in Hungary in common, no any accident. All patients' status were improved. There are some clinical investigation. The red is after the treatment, which means in this case that it's better. In this case, the lower is the better in the Ashworth score. Here is the red is better. Opinion search. For the patients, it was excellent because they feel that the caring is very intensive. They were absolutely not afraid sitting and grasping by two robots. For the physiotherapist, the teaching in procedure was a little bit clumsy because a physiotherapist did some motions, but for two robots it is impossible. For us engineers, this teaching in procedure is too slow. That's why we has got money from a Hungarian research council, so we are trying to improve the performance of those robotized cells. For example, we throw out one of the force-torque sensors and the safety release mechanism, and all of this is now such small. We improved even the user interface. The physiotherapist can test firstly the motion. It is a new project in Hungary for the economical development. We have got almost 1 million euro for developing further on this cell. This is the new robot controller with force control without that time. Honestly speaking, we will bought the first of this prototype. This will be the new robot. And there is another initiative in Hungary. We will use such kind of knowledge-based system to improve the pre-programming of the robots. Thank you for your attention, and first of all, thank you for the European Commission.